going to be d1 by 2. D1 is the pitch circle diameter and radius is half of that. So at this distance, the force is acting per bolt into number of bolts. So that is causing the total torque. Since you know the torque and everything else, you can find out F. So you know how much is the force acting at this place. Now this force is going to cause a bending moment. So as idea, the pin is, design of pin is already there. Pin is subjected to shear and bending stress. So if shear, how much is the shear stress here? Force upon area. So force is this F and the area is pi by 4 into dB square. This for one pin. And the other stress is the bending stress. So FT bending is equal to how much it is. Now this is going to be moment upon M upon I equal to F upon Y equal to E upon I. Already here M upon I is equal to F upon Y. So it is M upon Z. So stress is equal to M upon Z. Okay. So right here this M F FT is equal to M. Now what is M here? M is going to be force into distance is LP by 2. So force is F. Distance is LP upon 2. So this is a moment. And now this moment is acting at a distance of it is acting divided by Z. So Z for this is pi d cube by 32. Pi into d is dB. Okay. So these are the two stresses that are acting on the same section. Which section it is? On this section, at this section, these two stresses are acting, shear stress and bending stress. So we are now going to combine them by square root equation and find principal stresses. Find FT principal and F shear maximum. So by square root equation, we find these two by making use of these values. And now, once you get these principal stresses and the maximum shear stresses, they are to be checked whether they are less than the given design stresses or not. Okay, so that we will do right here. To find the principal stresses, so FT principal is equal to half of FT plus square root of FT square plus 4 times F shear square. So in this FT is this and F shear is this. So these values once you put here, that will give you the principal stress. Now this principal stress, see we have got all the dimensions. So you are going to get numerical values of this. So these numerical values you put here, then you will get the principal stress which should be less than the induced stress. So whether it is less than the FT induced or not, that is to be checked. Similarly, F shear maximum. This is equal to half of only this part. Which should be less than F shear induced. So if that is the case, then all the dimensions which are assumed here for the DB and even other things, they are all safe. Okay. So at this stage we are checked this particular part. Okay, for the failure in shearing and failure in bending. Now once this is done, most of the things are over. Now we have to go for the design of rubber bush. So now design of rubber bush. Now incidentally here in the data you are given crushing stress, design crushing stress for bush. It is also given. Now see what it means. This bush is under crushing action. If you see the bush, it is inside one hole here, and the outside diameter of the bush DO is touching to the hole which is there in this particular casting, that is the flange, and at that interface this diameter is experiencing a crushing stress. So I'll write here crushing stress so considering the crushing failure of this particular rubber bush, we'll write here F crushing design is equal to force upon area. Now force is the same force earlier because it is at same radius, and now what is going to be the area here? The area is diameter and length. So DO is the diameter, outside diameter of the bush, and length of the pin is more, but the contact is thickness of the flange, so into TF. Remember, we have to take here TF and not LP, because this bush is not in contact. Okay, the part which is in contact, only that length we have to take. So that is TF. So again, here TF is known, diameter of the bush is to be obtained. So this is not known, everything else is known. So you can find how much is going to be here, outside diameter of the bush. So outside diameter of the bush you have found out. And what is the inside diameter of the bush? DI is equal to, now DI is already take. Inside diameter. This inside diameter is DP plus, that means diameter of pin plus thickness of sleeve. So I will write here 2 times TS. Now TS is, in fact I have not written it properly, it should be this. So this black part which is shown, I'll draw it here separate. Here. This sleeve. So this black sleeve which is there, it is surrounding the pin. So its inside diameter is the outside diameter of the pin, and the outside diameter is the inside diameter of the bush. So DI. So we are talking about DI. So this DI is equal to DP plus TS twice. So this is TS, thickness of sleeve. So thickness of sleeve taken twice, that will give you DI. So we have got DI and DO both. Now the bushes, the total thickness of the bush is LP. Out of that, of course, TF is in contact. Okay. Now you can select certain number of bushes. So total length is LP here, this much. But out of that, TF is in contact, and then you can select certain number of bushes. So let NB is equal to number of bushes equal to 4 to 6. So depending on the length, you can have 4, 5, 6, 7 number of individual bushes. Now in this arrangement, we have to notice one thing, that the way it is drawn, if you see the way it is drawn, there is a pin. This pin is fitted here and then clamped by the nut. So now the pin will not move. The pin has got head here, and between the head and the other flange, between this space, all the rubber bushes are packed. And then outside that, there is a this side of flange. Now tell me, suppose the machine is stationary. Suppose I want to move this flange like this. Can it move? Suppose I want to take this flange completely out. I want to move it out. Is it possible to move it out? Now in the case of rigid coupling, it is not possible to move it out. It is not possible to separate the two flanges unless you unlock the nut. Now here I am not doing anything. The bolt is still in place. The nut is still in place. And I am trying to pull the flange away. Is it possible? The answer is yes, it is possible. Because if you see here, the diameter of the head is this much, and diameter of outside diameter of the bush is going to be more. So this head is not going to stop the movement of this flange. See, the movement of the flange can still take place at this place, from here, from this place it can still come out easily. It is purposely kept like this. So if required, you can move it back, but it doesn't happen on its own unless you physically move, pull it back. Till that time, it remains in position. So suppose you want to replace the bushes, then you can take the flange back, and then do whatever maintenance you have to do, change the bush, and again put it forward. Without, maybe you have to replace this, so you have to unlock the nut and change it. But that you don't have to say in case of a rigid coupling. Suppose something happens to the bolt, then you have to completely take the motors or the load and the motor away. Now that will not happen here. The shafts will still remain in the same position. Okay, that is a difference. So there are certain differences in the case of a flexible coupling. And now, as far as the design is considered, we have seen the changes, the difference compared to the rigid coupling. Whatever is the difference, that difference we have seen how it is taken care of and how do we design. So in just to summarize, what we have done is, in the design of this flexible coupling, certain things are common. The new thing is how to design the pin, and for the pin we are considering the force here. Now this pin is experiencing a bending stress as well as shear stress, so we are combining by principal stress equation, and then check that principal stress are less than the induced stress. That was one thing. Then we have designed the outside diameter of the bush. The rest everything were available by empirical relation, and all those dimensions got automatically checked because they were all involved in different calculations. So since all the dimensions were involved, the design is getting saved. Certain dimensions are such that they are not so critical. Okay, they are just by proportion. Say for example, D2 outside diameter, how much it is? It's just by proportion. Okay, it doesn't carry any physical or stresses. They are not carrying any stresses. Similarly, you know this Y. How much do you take Y? For that, you will see here. I'll write one small equation. Maybe somewhere here. B plus Y is equal to LP plus thickness of pin head plus 2 to 3 mm. So this is 2 to 3 mm. Just because it should remain inside. So that becomes the equation. So out of that, we know LP. But one more thing, LP is equal to thickness of flange plus Y. So you know LP, you know TF, so you can find out Y. So this Y you get, this you are getting. So you will obtain this Y, and this Y when you put here, then everything else is known, and then you will find out how much is B you can keep. Okay, this is all just a proportionate kind of exercise, nothing big in this, no stress calculations, only suitable sizes we are taking in certain places. Okay, so that completes the design of a rigid pin and boost type flexible coupling. Okay, so we will be preparing one practical on this where I will be giving you the data, and then based on the data, this is what you have to do. Now, here one more thing you will find that the bushes, the outside diameter, this DO of the bush, you will get certain value. And suppose now there are six such bolts, then what will happen is sometimes maybe I'll draw here. I am drawing this flange like this, and suppose there are six bolts required, then this outside diameter of the bush is, suppose it is very big, then you will find it difficult to accommodate six bushes. In this case, what is done is, three bushes are here and three bushes are opposite. So you can now see that all the six bushes, they are equally placed. That means 60 degree angle, if there are six bushes, it is 60 degrees as it should be. But then three bolts will be like this and three bolts will be like this. So three from this side, three from this side. So what will happen? The bushes will be here and the bolts will be here. Okay, and the other way, bushes will be here and bolts will be here. So three bolts from this side and the other three bolts are from this side. So that way, in that case, when you do like this, this flange and this flange will be same. Although here I am showing the diameter here is more, diameter is less. There will be three holes of this size, and on this flange there will be three holes of this size also. So 3 plus 3, 6, same thing here. That means in that case the flange will be same. That means you have to draw one flange and you have to make quantity 2. Because they are identical and number of parts for the flange are 2. Okay? Because this is the way you can do it. But if you don't do like this, then accommodating all the six bushes on one flange, it could be perhaps difficult. So if that is the case, do it like this, depending on how the data is. Okay, so that is what we are going to solve this in the practical. Thank you.